In today's Excel VBA video, I'm going to show you how you can allow the user to select a file from Excel's Open dialog box. Now I'm going to show this to you with the GetOpenFilename method. But why would you want to do this? It's for flexibility. So you want to give the user, basically the user of your macro or your file, the flexibility to pick the file on which your macro should run on. And once you get the path of the file, you can do anything you need to do on the file. You can open the file, you can import certain tabs, look for specific information, basically anything that has a logic behind that can be programmed. The advantage of handing over control to the user here is that you don't have to fix the path of the file in the VBA code. You don't even have to type it in Excel cells. You let them freely select it. But the challenge is to get your macro to figure out what they selected. Let's take a look. What we want to do is to bring up that open dialog box. We want them to select a file, and then we want to open that file in the background and copy a specific range. So in our example, we're just going to do a small range of sheet 1 and paste it right here, starting from cell A10, right? So this is just a very simple example. Later, we're actually gonna use multi-selection here. So we're gonna open multiple files in the background and copy specific ranges and import them in our file. But here, we're just gonna start simple and work with one file. Let's bring up Visual Basic, Alt F11, and create a new sub-procedure for this. First off, let's just take a look at what this GetOpenFilename method means. Well, first of all, this method is a method of the application object, which means all I have to do is type in application.getOpenFilename. That's it. I'm going to run this to see what I get. I get Excel's open dialog box here. You can see the title is open. It defaults to all files here, but these are things that you can control in the code. If you don't put any of the arguments in, that's the default that you get. Now, if I press cancel, nothing happens. Let's just now select something. If I click this and say open, nothing happens, right? So that file isn't actually opened. Let's see what this does by going to Microsoft Help. So I'm just gonna click here and press F1. The GetOpenFilename method displays the standard open dialog box, which we saw earlier. It gets a file name from the user without actually opening any files. So all it does when the user clicks on OK is that it gets a file name. These are the arguments that it requires. Now all of them are optional. So you can define a file filter if you don't want it to default to all files. You can define it, but you need to define it in a specific format that's described here under remarks. So for example, for text files, add-in files, and so on, or Visual Basic files, you have to define it like this. I'm going to show you how you need to define it for Excel files. Now you can also overwrite the title, the button text. You can only if you have a Mac. And you can also use multi-select. Let's go back to our VBA code and see how we can expand on this. We saw that all we get is a file name, right? So it makes sense to declare that as a variable. I'm gonna dim file to open. Now we're used to declaring these as string, right? So let's declare it as string in this case as well. Then we're gonna say file to open equals application.getOpenFilename. Let's define the title for it as well. Now, if you use arguments like this, you don't have to follow any specific order. That's going to be our title. For file filter, we need to put it in this way if we wanted to filter only for Excel files. That's it. Now, let's see what value we get in this variable. The watch window is here. Let me activate that by going to view watch window, and I'm going to drag this down here and keep an eye on this value. I'm going to add a breakpoint. Let's run this. Okay, let's select a file. I'm going to go with test data here and click on open. Look at the value it got. It's the entire path plus the file name. Now check this out. Let's run this again. This time, I'm going to click on cancel. The value that it gets is false, but notice that it's put it in quotation marks, so it thinks it's text. Because I've dimmed file to open a string, what it's then going to do is try to open a file called false, and that's not what we wanted to do. So if we want to check whether a user actually clicked a valid file or not, we can check if file to open is false or not. But we shouldn't dim it as string, but instead variant, because variant can be Boolean as well, right? So let's reset this. And now let's click on cancel. And we see false, but false is not in quotation marks, right? So it's not recognized as text. This is something that you need to keep in mind when you're defining a variable for your getOpenFilename method. So right here, we can check if file2open does not equal to false. It means that an actual file was selected. Then, let's do an endif here. We want to open that workbook. So for that, it also makes sense to declare a variable, right, for the workbook that we want to open. Let's call it dimOpenBook as workbook. Since that's an object, we need to use the set keyword. So set openbook equals, that's application.workbooks.open. This requires the entire path, which is what? File to open. Now we want to copy data from this. I've specified here copy range A1 E20 of sheet 1. Let's do openbook.sheets1, right? So first is the workbook object, then it's the worksheet object, and then it's the range object. So range A1 to E20.copy. And we're going to paste it right here in this workbook.worksheets. Now we can work either with the code name of the sheet or just use the sheet name. The name of this sheet is called select file dot, we said we want to paste it in range A10 dot paste special. Let's paste it as values only with Excel paste values. When we're opening a workbook in the background, we should also close it after we're done. And we can do that simply by selecting the workbook, which we've called openbook dot close. An optional argument for this is if you want to save changes. We haven't changed anything. I'm just going to put false in here. Now, just to optimize this, because we're opening other workbooks in the background, our screen is going to flicker. We can add application.screenUpdating equals false, and then we can set it back to true right at the end. Let's just test this here. I'm going to insert a button, assign it to our new macro, and just call this import data. Okay, so let's click on this. We get prompted to select a file. Now you can go through all your normal files and folders. I'm going to go here. I have some data in this file that we can test and import here. If you're interested to get access to the bonus files or to the PDF handout, or if you'd like to learn VBA from the ground up in a structured way, please check out the complete course and see if it's something for you. Link is in the description below. It's also in the YouTube course provided, and you can also find it on my site, xclplus.com/courses. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video, or see you inside the course.